give the floor to His Excellency Mr. Omar Abdulrashid Ali Shamaki, Prime Minister of the Federal Republic of Somalia. Prime Minister.
Mr. President, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to be present with you here today to participate in discussions on taking Somalia forward. It's indeed an honor for Somalia and to all of us here. Somalia cannot thank the Council enough for all it has done to support her over the years. I was pleased to hear from the speakers before me today of their optimism and commitment to support the progress that Somalia is making. I would like to welcome the UK Foreign Secretary, Mr. Philip Hammond, and laud him for his leadership in chairing today's meeting. I would also like to thank the SRSG, Mr. Nicholas Kay, for his role in Somalia for the last 2.5 years. Those must have been two difficult but also rewarding years for him in terms of the progress that Somalia has made in his tenure as the SRSG. Mr. Kay has been steadfast in his support and optimally infectious about his optimism for Somalia. It is not uplifting at all that he has not been left to complete the process. He has invested so much effort and emotions to help shape it up with the national and international partners. Not especially now that Somalia is experiencing an all-time collective crescendo momentum on the political process. I'd like to assure him and the Council that Somalia's political leadership, both at the federal and regional levels, are committed to take forward what is in the best interest of their people and country. All of us recognize that in the best interest of Somalia to complete the state-building electoral process within the mandate of the current government, which ends in August 2016. As all the previous speakers attest to, significant progress has been made in Somalia in almost all fronts on security and political. In this early stage of rebuilding, our government has yet to bolster the economic sector as we have on the political and security sectors. With much more remaining to be done, as leaders, we are prepared to go the extra mile to register more progress. The progress in Somalia since the government took over the reins of leadership towards the end of 2012, the challenges that have to be overcome and tasks still outstanding have all been covered in great detail during the last high-level partnership forum held in Mogadishu on July 29 and 30. We are certain to talk about even greater milestone in the next high-level partnership, sometimes in February 2016. We encourage high-level participation, and we hope both you, Mr. President, and the UN Secretary General, Ban Ki-moon, will join us to take stock of achievement, challenges, and plan for spring lab to election in 2016. As the Council is well aware, we had a series of top-level meetings on the political process in the month of October, which culminated in the inauguration of the National Consultative Forum. Its maiden plenary session was held in Mogadishu on 19 and 20 October, drawing together high-level representation from all existing four regional administrations, led by their respective presidents, to the top leadership of the federal government of Somalia, as well as representatives from our international partners. Regional level consultation will start in earnest in matters of days ahead of the National Consultative Forum meeting in December to discuss and unveil the best possible election option in the absence of one person, one vote, and agree on a timeline for electoral process for election that must happen in 2016. I'm pleased to say the process in establishing the last and the final interim regional administration has officially begun. A technical committee that will manage the process has been put together. We expect to welcome the birth of a new regional administration, Hiran and Middle Shoele, by the end of the year. The constitutional review process is in progress. Although we're not happy with the pace of progress, the institutions concerned are progressing in a manner that has never been seen before. The United Nations facilitated a workshop on constitutional review with stakeholders' participation was recently held in Mogadishu under my stewardship. A review of two chapters have been concluded, and we expect the remainder to be fast-tracked. There is no refuting that we made gains in the security sector. To cement gains, the leadership of the federal government of Somalia has made public of our commitment to security sector reform, especially on the area of transparency and accountability. Force integration progress is underway. The Gulwe plan, or the victory plan, is key to the success of the integration process. What has not been inspiring, however, is the lack of donor support for this plan, as elaborated as the plan is. SNA still lacks equipment, training, and logistical support. This has hampered our ability to leverage or the benefit of force integration in terms of envisioned sustained offensive operations against Al-Shabaab. The federal government of Somalia, while committed, still faces challenges to assume a full responsibility for asylum returning to the security forces. Once we attain this goal, which we hope by January 2016 we will, we hope to redirect stipends from the support from our partners to further support equipment, training, and logistical support. Despite the military gains against Al-Shabaab that the council members mentioned, Al-Shabaab's recent offensive attack against Amazon and SNA targets is disconcerting, to say the least. Complex attacks against hotels is now an indication that those Somali and international partners have won the battles against Al-Shabaab. They have yet to be demolished. Somalia's terror network recent proclamation of allegiance to ISIS is not to be taken lightly. With modest gains against this terror organization, Somalia cannot afford to have space for ISIS to explode and reverse the hard-earned progress on security that Amazon and SNA sacrificed lives. That's why we need support of the Council more than ever before, to stand with Somalia against this terror network, to deny it the ability to regroup or pose renewed threat in Somalia and the region. Resolution of the crisis in Yemen is crucial. Such will go a long way in keeping Al-Shabaab from acquiring support from ISIS, using Yemen as a conduit or launching pad. The other anchor that is necessary in rallying support for the goal of the plan. The federal government is committed to build the ability of its security forces to absorb the kind of support that they expect from our international partners. That's the job of the SNA leadership, and that was the essence of effecting recent SNA leadership change at the top to effect reform, both strategic, technical, and operational. As the federal government of Somalia is prepared to back them up with progressive policy and civilian control. There is a serious need for Amazon and SNA to reflect on recent attacks on their bases. The scores that Al-Shabaab is collecting against compromises the confidence of the Somali people to confront Al-Shabaab. We welcome and encourage our international partners' effort to eliminate the leadership of Al-Shabaab. We owe it to Amazon and SNA to fulfill its commitment in defeating them. And finally, on security, while our special forces have performed impeccably well in saving lives in real time, in the face of complex attack on civilians' business premises, our intelligence and preemptive capacity remain quite wanting. Because of systematic intelligence shortcomings, our people are made to suffer preventable losses. This must end. It is disappointing that we seem to have resorted to verbal condemnation of Al-Shabaab. Their tactics are well known. We must focus further on action. With better coordination among Amazon forces and Amazon and SNA, we can again turn the tables against them and remove their ability to pose any real threat to civilian or military targets. Thanks to the Council anti-piracy resolution, we have seen almost no incidents of piracy for the last 2 years or so in Somali waters. While the result is reassuring, there is a need for sustainability. There is a need to protect the livelihood of the coastal community, long ravaged by piracy activities along Somalia's coast. Somalia needs the support of the Council on illegal, unreported, unregulated fishing in Somalia's waters. Lastly, poverty and lack of economic prosperity plays a major role in appealing to extremism and terrorism. Uneducated, underemployed, and unemployed youth continues to be a ticking time bomb for Somalia, time that we cannot afford to waste. Investment in Somalia in supporting job creation initiatives, education, vocational training, and other basic infrastructure development programs will lead to true stability and sustainability. There are examples in the region to draw from that show appeal to violent extremism decrease with individual or societal prosperity. On our part as a government, we are putting in place the necessary legal framework to attract and guarantee investments. Once again, I'd like to thank the Council and its leadership for promoting world peace and prosperity in general and for its continued support to the people of Somalia. Thank you.
I thank Prime Minister Shamaki for his statement.